The presidential election of 1948 was never in doubt, according to the pollsters. The Chicago Tribune printed its famous headline, "Dewey defeats Truman." And then came the morning after.
This is the news. The president of the United States and the next president of the United States says he just wants to deserve the honor. A jubilant Harry Truman told reporters, "All my efforts will be devoted to the cause of peace in the world and peace and prosperity at home." At the present time, with the vote count still incomplete, the president is leading in 28 states with an electoral vote of 304, 266 needed to elect. Governor Dewey is leading in 16 states with an electoral vote of 189. In the popular vote, the president has 1.5 million more than the governor. Henry Wallace has 995,000. Governor Thurmond, 823,000. The Democrats have made a net gain of 8 Senate seats. 49 are necessary for control. The Democrats have 52. In the House, the Democrats gained 69 seats. 218 are necessary to control, and they have 253, so they control both houses by a comfortable majority. It would, of course, be possible to exhaust all the adjectives in the book in an effort to describe what happened yesterday, why it happened, and what consequences may be expected to flow from the decision freely taken by the American people. For weeks and months, both the analysts and the apologists will be busy examining the labor vote, the farm vote, the size of the total vote, and the strategy of the two major parties. And there will be many explanations, much second-guessing, considerable sympathy for those whose high hopes of office and honors have been frustrated. I do not pretend to know why the people voted as they did, for the people are mysterious, and their motives are not to be measured. This election result has demonstrated that. It has, in a measure, demechanized our society, freed us to a certain extent from the tyranny of those who tell us what we think, believe, and will do without consulting us. No one at this moment can say with certainty why the Republicans lost or why the Democrats won. And I do not think it matters, for the people are sovereign, and they have decided.